my name is Pam Hoyle, and I'm a math specialist at Bass Hoover Elementary School here in Frederick County, Virginia. I've created a short video to introduce the game Hopscotch as a way to practice skip counting and finding multiples. Skip counting is essential as it lays a mathematical foundation for developing a student's ability with other mathematical skills. Counting forwards and backwards in ones, twos, fives, and other multiples are strategies that may be used to solve addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division problems. This will then help with the skills needed to find patterns in numbers and understand fractions. Skip counting begins as early as kindergarten, but for this video, we're going to focus on grades 2 through 5. To play hopscotch, you'll need chalk, a hard surface, and a small object for tossing, such as a rock, acorn, or stick. First, draw your hopscotch board. There are several options to choose from. Choose which multiple you would like to use for your skip counting. So if you choose the number 2, you would write 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, etc. You choose the number 6, 6, 12, 18, 24, etc., as long as you fill up the squares on the board. As you hop through the squares, say the number out loud as you're going through, and this will help with the development of understanding the multiples. Once you're confident with skip counting within the numbers on the game board, create a new board and start at a different multiple. For example, if you're counting by fives, instead of starting at 5, start at 30, and so forth. This is your game. You can change the rules as you see fit. Families can help support their students by using tools such as a number line, yardstick, or measuring tape to help students skip count by a given number. You can limit the numbers used on the board or start with known multiples such as 2, 5s, or 10s to practice. Families can also support deeper understanding by asking what multiple comes before or after the number you landed on. Can you start counting at a number other than the first multiple you used? How can knowing multiples of different numbers help you with multiplication or division? This is for 3rd through 5th graders. How does this relate to fractions and denominators? Again, higher level thinking for those who have been introduced to fractions. There are many other outdoor games that lend themselves to learning. Think back to your childhood times and the games you played and see if you can incorporate math into them to teach your child.